the PCOO, Presidential Communications Operations Office of Malacanang. President Duterte pledges immediate assistance to typhoon survivors, right? The government is on top of the situation following the devastation of Typhoon Ulysses. Okay, according to President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, he said yesterday as he vowed immediate assistance to affected communities. All right. Well, following kita nyo naman yung the devastation na ginawa ni Typhoon Ulysses, ano? Devastation. Pagkasira, ha? Hindi po yung ano yung pinagsasakyan ninyo ng ano kung saan kayo sumasakay para sumakay ng bus. Devastation yon. Devastation, right? Now, sabi ni President Duterte, as president, I guarantee you that your government will do its best to provide assistance in the form of shelters, relief goods, financial aid, and post-disaster counseling. All right? And the president also said that even before Typhoon Ulysses made its first landfall, alam niyo naman, Typhoon Ulysses made its landfall 3 times. Have you guys heard? Tatlong beses naglandfall. Various government agencies have already been mobilized to respond to the situation on the ground, sabi ni Presidente, even before its first landfall. Alright? Sabi pa niya, but all of this, lahat, pati yung mga sundalo, nauna na po yan. Alright? Iyan po lang yung dumating ang advisory sa atin. Nakapondo na yung mga tao. The goods are there, the people have been mobilized and deployed, kaya pagdating ng bagyo, nandyan, nagtatrabaho na sila. Diba? Kasi yung iba na naman, eh na naman ang comment eh. Wala na namang daw ginagawa. Even before the first landfall, naka-ready na po. Eh, alam nga nang sumugod yung ano, yung, well, yung mga rescue teams, syempre, gumagalaw. Alright? Pero yung delivery of goods and services, hindi pa makakapag-deliver, syempre, nung kasalukuyang bumabayo. Sayang yung mga i-deliver nila kung mababasa, syempre, pagkatapos na humupa, doon sila kikilos ngayon. Yung mga i-deliver na goods and services. Alright? Pero make no mistake about it, rescue teams are all over. I know, medyo kinapos dahil ang daming nangailangan ng tulong talaga eh. We were overwhelmed. Alright? Okay? Also, the president noted that government's security forces and rescue teams have the tools and equipments to help people in disaster areas. Alright? They flaunted new government assets even. He said the Coast Guard and the Navy will use their vessels to rescue people, while Air Force air assets were dispatched. Okay, in his statement, President Duterte made a renewed call on local government units or LGUs and other agencies to exhaust all resources in ensuring that the well-being and safety of our people remain the top priority. Okay, so ayan ha, sa buong Pilipinas to. All right. LGUs, sabi ni Presidente, exhaust all efforts and resources that you have para tulungan yung madlang people, sambayan ng people natin. Okay? So there you have it, the latest from the Presidential Communications Operations Office. If you wanna read more about it, if you wanna get, you know, keep updated, look up the Presidential Communications Operations Office official website. Just Google it. Okay? It will show the PCOO of Malacanang. Okay. So there you have it. And next up, time for me now to give you the latest COVID-19 update. First up, of course, is the update from our dear SBMA Chairman and Administrator, COVID-19 update for Subic Bay Freeport Zone. For the SBFZ residents, we have a total confirmed cases 36 with 33 recoveries, 1 reported death. So SBFZ remains 2 active cases remains. All right, and SBFC transients this time 27 confirmed cases, 26 recoveries, 1 has relocated, and 0 current active cases. For SBMA employees, we had a total of 25 confirmed cases with 24 recoveries, and one active case remains for SBMA employees. All right, and to round up the other COVID-19 updates, this one's for Olongapo City this time. 888 total confirmed cases, all right, and from which 779 has recovered with 30 deaths. Okay, so the remaining active cases for Longapo City, 79. Mm-hmm. All right, and now let's go to the province of Zambales. For the province of Zambales, the total confirmed cases, 608. 589 has recovered, all right, with 6 reported deaths, leaving the province of Zambales with a total 13 active cases. And let's go now to the update from Bataan. For Bataan, we have a total 2,839 confirmed cases with 2,635 recoveries, 55 reported deaths, leaving Bataan, the province of Bataan, with a total 149 active cases. All right. And lastly, the national update for the entire country. We had a total of 398,449. Malapit nang pumalo sa 400,000. I think papalo na with the latest addition, almost 2,000 yun eh. But I don't have the final figure yet, so I can't announce it just yet. I think it's about 400,000 na. Okay? Pero as of the current update from the Department of Health page, 398,449 total active cases. I mean, total confirmed cases, not the total active. The total confirmed, lahat-lahat kasali. Yung na-test positive, currently nagpapagaling, pati na rin yung number of deaths kasama dyan. 398,449. And recoveries, ilan ang naka-recover doon in that total figure? 361,784. Number of reported death, 7,647. Leaving the entire country with a total active cases of 29,018. Okay, so there you have it. The COVID-19 update for today, November 13, 2020. The updates for the Subic Bay Freeport Zone, Olongapo, Bataan, Zambales, and the national tally. Alright, once again people, if you guys want to request for songs, you text me up 0910-6909-501. Once again, 0910-6909-501. And we are also streaming live on Facebook. Just look it up, the official Facebook page of 89.5 Subic Bay Radio. Also live on the Morning Brew page and the Friday Rewind page. Okay, and before I press play on the next requested song, I want to give a big shout out to everybody in the live